Embroidery. Embroidery is the craft of decorating fabric or other materials using a needle to apply thread or yarn. Embroidery may also incorporate other materials such as pearls, beads, quills, and sequins. In modern days, embroidery is usually seen on caps, hats, coats, blankets, dress shirts, denim, dresses, stockings, and golf shirts. Embroidery is available with a wide variety of thread or yarn color. Some of the basic techniques or stitches of the earliest embroidery are chain stitch, buttonhole or blanket stitch, running stitch, satin stitch, cross stitch. Those stitches remain the fundamental techniques of hand embroidery today. The process used to tailor, patch, mend and reinforce cloth fostered the development of sewing techniques, and the decorative possibilities of sewing led to the art of embroidery. Indeed, the remarkable stability of basic embroidery stitches has been noted. The art of embroidery has been found worldwide and several early examples have been found. Works in China have been dated to the Warring States period 5th-3rd century BC. In a garment from migration period Sweden, roughly 300 to 700 AD, the edges of bands of trimming are reinforced with running stitch, back stitch, stem stitch, tailor's buttonhole stitch, and whip stitching, but it is uncertain whether this work simply reinforced the seams or should be interpreted as decorative embroidery. Ancient Greek mythology has credited the goddess Athena with passing down the art of embroidery along with weaving, leading to the famed competition between herself and the mortal Arachne. Depending on time, location and materials available, embroidery could be the domain of a few experts or a widespread, popular technique. This flexibility led to a variety of works, from the royal to the mundane. Elaborately embroidered clothing, religious objects, and household items often were seen as a mark of wealth and status, as in the case of Opus Anglicanum, a technique used by professional workshops and guilds in medieval England. In 18th century England and its colonies, samplers employing fine silks were produced by the daughters of wealthy families. Embroidery was a skill marking a girl's path into womanhood as well as conveying rank and social standing. Conversely, embroidery is also a folk art, using materials that were accessible to non-professionals. Examples include Hardanger from Norway, Mereshka from Ukraine, Mount Malik embroidery from Ireland, Nakshi Kanta from Bangladesh and West Bengal, and Brazilian embroidery. Many techniques had a practical use such as sashiko from Japan, which was used as a way to reinforce clothing. Embroidery was an important art in the medieval Islamic world. The 17th century Turkish traveler Evliya Çelebi called it the craft of the two hands. Because embroidery was a sign of high social status in Muslim societies, it became widely popular. In cities such as Damascus, Cairo, and Istanbul, embroidery was visible on handkerchiefs, uniforms, flags, calligraphy, shoes, robes, tunics, horse trappings, slippers, sheaths, pouches, covers, and even on leather belts. Craftsmen embroidered items with gold and silver thread. Embroidery cottage industries, some employing over 800 people, grew to supply these items. In the 16th century, in the reign of the Mughal Emperor Akbar, his chronicler Abu al-Fazl ibn Mubarak wrote in the famous Ain Akbari, "His Majesty, Akbar, pays much attention to various stuffs, hence Irani, Ottoman, and Mongolian articles of wear are in much abundance, especially textiles embroidered in the patterns of Nakshi, Saadi, Chikan, Ari, Zardozi, Wesley, Gotha and Khora." The imperial workshops in the towns of Lahore, Agra, Fatehpur and Ahmedabad turn out many masterpieces of workmanship in fabrics, and the figures and patterns, knots and variety of fashions which no prevail astonish even the most experienced travelers. Taste for fine material has since become general, and the drapery of embroidered fabrics used at feasts surpasses every description. The development of machine embroidery and its mass production came about in stages in the Industrial Revolution. The earliest machine embroidery used a combination of machine looms and teams of women embroidering the textiles by hand. This was done in France by the mid-1800s. The manufacture of machine-made embroideries in St. Gallen in eastern Switzerland flourished in the latter half of the 19th century. Embroidery can be classified according to what degree the design takes into account the nature of the base material and by the relationship of stitch placement to the fabric. The main categories are free or surface embroidery, counted embroidery, and needlepoint or canvas work. In free or surface embroidery, designs are applied without regard to the weave of the underlying fabric. Examples include crewel and traditional Chinese and Japanese embroidery. Counted thread embroidery patterns are created by making stitches over a predetermined number of threads in the foundation fabric. Counted thread embroidery is more easily worked on an even weave foundation fabric such as embroidery canvas, i.e. the cloth, or specially woven cotton and linen fabrics. Examples include cross stitch and some forms of blackwork embroidery. While similar to counted thread in regards to technique, in canvas work or needlepoint, threads are stitched through a fabric mesh to create a dense pattern that completely covers the foundation fabric. Examples of canvas work include bargello and Berlin wool work. Embroidery can also be classified by the similarity of appearance. In drawn thread work and cut work, the foundation fabric is deformed or cut away to create holes that are then embellished with embroidery, often with thread in the same color as the foundation fabric. When created with white thread on white linen or cotton, this work is collectively referred to as white work. However, white work can either be counted or free. Hardanger embroidery is a counted embroidery and the designs are often geometric. Conversely, styles such as broderie anglaise are similar to free embroidery, with floral or abstract designs that are not dependent on the weave of the fabric. The fabrics and yarns used in traditional embroidery vary from place to place. Wool, linen, and silk have been in use for thousands of years for both fabric and yarn. Today, embroidery thread is manufactured in cotton, rayon, and novelty yarns as well as in traditional wool, linen, and silk. Ribbon embroidery uses narrow ribbon and silk or silk/organza blend ribbon, most commonly to create floral motifs. Surface embroidery techniques such as chain stitch and couching or laid work are the most economical of expensive yarns. Couching is generally used for gold work. Canvas work techniques, in which large amounts of yarn are buried on the back of the work, use more materials but provide a sturdier and more substantial finished textile. In both canvas work and surface embroidery, an embroidery hoop or frame can be used to stretch the material and ensure even stitching tension that prevents pattern distortion. Modern canvas work tends to follow symmetrical counted stitching patterns with designs emerging from the repetition of one or just a few similar stitches in a variety of hues. In contrast, many forms of surface embroidery make use of a wide range of stitching patterns in a single piece of work. Contemporary embroidery is stitched with a computerized embroidery machine using patterns digitized with embroidery software. In machine embroidery, different types of fills add texture and design to the finished work. Machine embroidery is used to add logos and monograms to business shirts or jackets, gifts, and team apparel, as well as to decorate household linens, draperies, and decorator fabrics that mimic the elaborate hand embroidery of the past. Machine embroidery is most typically done with rayon thread, although polyester thread can also be used. Cotton thread, on the other hand, is prone to breaking and should be avoided if under 30 weight. There has also been a development in freehand machine embroidery. New machines have been designed that allow for the user to create free motion embroidery, which has its place in textile arts, quilting, dressmaking, home furnishings, and more. Users can use the embroidery software to digitize the digital embroidery designs. These digitized designs are then transferred to the embroidery machine with the help of a flash drive, and then the embroidery machine embroiders the selected design onto the fabric. City and Guilds qualification in embroidery allows embroiderers to become recognized for their skill. This qualification also gives them the credibility to teach. For example, the notable textiles artist, Kathleen Laurel Sage, began her teaching career by getting the City and Guilds Embroidery 1 and 2 qualifications. She has now gone on to write a book on the subject. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.